Hi, this is Brett Hodson. I'm going to give you a quick overview of the Sage 300 CRE Project Management Module, otherwise known as PJ. This video is going to be geared towards people that are current Sage 300 CRE users and are looking to see what adding this particular module to their setup, what gains it will offer them. So let's get started. What you see right here is just the desktop. You have a desktop page showing some of the information that can reside in the project management or PJ module. So let's go ahead and open up PJ project management. And we're going to start with setup, covering a few things that you can do while you're using the Sage 300 CRE project management module. The first thing that you can do above and beyond with just job cost is that you can store a list of site contacts. When you send out emails, it'll have this default information in the system for you. The second thing is there's additional inquiries and reports that ship with this module. We have a complete database listing of all those. Just send us a request. We're happy to email those to you. But let's just go ahead and look at a job inquiry that's built in. This is a job overview inquiry, and this does a very nice job of pulling together original contracts, pending contract changes, approved contract changes, revised contracts. So this is the revenue side of things, total cost budget estimate, commitments, which would be all your purchase orders and subcontracts, job to date costs, projected cost of completion, anticipated profit, what we build so far, and some RFI document type information. And of course, the drill downs that are in here work just the same as everything else. So if you want to drill down and see all the purchase orders and subcontracts, you certainly can. If you want to look at job to date costs, you can do that. And all the functionality that you're used to with the other modules is also here in the project management module. The key to pull downs are documents and contract control. Contract control are all about accounting type functions. The enter estimates is exactly the same as it's in the job cost module. It just gives you a place to do it here. As well as the commitments menu is the same that you have in job cost. You can just do POs and subcontracts here, or you can do them in job cost either way. Documents is a new item that you gain by having project management. You can keep a drawing log. This is not a plan grid or anything like that. It is a basic drawing log that'll let you have a list of drawings that you can pull up on the screen and keep track of revisions and so on. And so if I wanted to look at one of the particular jobs, I could pull that up and look at the drawings. In this case, I don't have any on this particular project. If we go look at Northwest Food Warehouse, we can see the drawings that are here, and you could attach files to them. So it's basically would replace a spreadsheet for you. Meeting minutes, for those of you who need to keep track of meeting minutes, you can keep track of a meeting, delegate items to individuals, and send out an agenda and keep track of meeting minutes. Submittals, again, it's a log type system here, so you can keep track of submittals for projects. So let's say we want to look at the Officers Park project. We could pull that up, look at the different spec sections and see the information that's available to us on these and revise them as see fit. Essentially printing out, keeping track of if it's approved and so on. With regards to RFIs, there is some workflow that go along with RFIs. So let's bring up the office park job. So here's the office park job. We can see a list of RFIs that we have available to us. And again, I'm going to bring up the office park job. So we can see all the ones that are in here. So here we on RFI 9, we'd found a tank. But let's go ahead and just create a new one. And let's say we need to install a street light per county requirements. And I'm just going to repeat that as my question here. Do you want us to quote this to you? So this would be the RFI. We think it's going to require 3 days of work. And, you know, we don't really know how much, but we think it's going to be somewhere about $50,000 to do that. So we can put this information together and we can email it out of your Sage Timberline system. It will attach as a PDF using Outlook as the method to send it out. The PDF that gets sent out with the email is a crystal report design. These can be modified to your specifications. So let's say that the subcontractor, or in this case, the architect, responds and saying, go ahead and put a quote together. So any type of response has to be keyed in like this. There's no pulling in from an email. You would just open up your email and cut and paste into here. But what you can do is that you can take this information and use it to pre-fill a change request. So let's go ahead and do that. So now we're on change request number 23 for this, and we're going to say streetlight and other improvements. And we're just going to put that as the scope. And then this tab right here is where we're going to price it up. And we could price up. We know that there's going to be some demo, and we think that's going to be about $1,500, around $1,000 worth of material. And we called a couple of our subs, and they said, we're going to estimate that a little bit high at $60,000. So those are the prices I put in here. And now, let's go ahead and close out of this RFI. And I'm going to come over here to change requests. So this is going to show me all the change requests that are in here for this particular project. I have quite a few. And you can see that last one that we've just put in here, streetlights and other improvements, it hasn't been issued yet. So if I click on that, I see those details. I can review them here. I have my markups here. And again, I can email those directly out of the system. It's going to attach it as a PDF to the email. So this is what that change request looks like that we're going to submit to our customer. Now, let's say that we get a response from our customer and they say, yeah, you know, let's go ahead and put a change order together for us. And this is what the change order screen looks like. I'm going to make it a little bit smaller. So to build a change order, you do the following. So we're on change order number 13 for this project. And you'll notice right here that to build a change order is built upon change requests. I have two change requests in here that haven't been attached to a change order previously. So our customer said, yeah, go ahead and we're good to go on those change requests. One of the things you can also do with a change order is that you can attach it to your schedule of values. So that would be a contract item. And you have a couple choices here. You can have it revise an existing contract item, or you could set up a brand new contract item. And that's what I'm going to do here. So I'm going to set up contract item number 26. And it's change order 13. It's progress billing. It's attached to this job. So click OK. So it's 71.5. And we're going to say it's approved. And let's go ahead and email that out. Now, one of the things you're going to see right here is it's going to say, hey, you're going to issue that revenue change order, but you also need to update your budget estimate so that that way the budget gets updated on your job cost too. So let's go ahead and take a look and see what that document looks like. So here is the two change request items, and here's the previous contract with the owner, and now the revised amount. So that can be sent out and processed also. So far, we've taken a project, we've had a change request, it's turned into a change order. If we go back here to the contract, you can see here that we have all this information right here. And the last thing that we might want to do or need to do is go ahead and let's issue a change order to that, to the subcontracts. So right down here under commitment change orders, this is where we would take for the office park job, those approved change requests and attach them to a change order. So I'm going to go ahead and work on back on change order 7. I have some commitments that we haven't sent out to the sub yet. So let's go ahead and do that. So it's as simple as just selecting them. It's going to attach those items to a change order. In this case, it's commitment 2321, change order 1 to the subcontractor. And again, we can print preview those and see what those look like here. And there's our recap to Beaverton Sand and Gravel. Again, the format of these are really up to you. You can vary these as you see fit. They're built upon Crystal Reports. So that gives a quick overview of what you can do with regards to inputting and producing documents in the PJ Project Management Module, as well as change order management. One final thing is Sage 300 CRE, you do have the ability to do projections in the job cost module. Likewise, you can do projections here in the project management module. So if I wanted to do like projected cost of completion for my projects, you could do that here too. So if I had the office park job, I can go ahead and look at where we're at today. So these are my current cost of completions. We're doing this at the group levels. And I have some other data here on the screen that I can see as I'm working along. So I could go ahead and revise these as we see fit. So instead of at 108,500, you know, I could say, yeah, I think our cost of completion, we're going to be more about like 95K. So again, you could update these as you see fit, and then those would filter through to your reports. Last item before we close out is to just go back and look at the billing side of things. So again, if you're doing your progress billing through your Sage 300 CRE system, if you remember, we went ahead and set up a new contract item for this project, and it would be at, picked the wrong project. Let's go ahead and try that again. So we wanted to pick job, the office park job. And you can see right here that those change orders are here as new contract items. on the screen. So there's that new contract item. And if we were ready to invoice the customer for it, we could go ahead and invoice the customer on this AIA progress style bill. So that concludes the demonstration of Sage PJ Project Management. If you have any further questions about it, please get in touch. Thank you very much.